Hey man, is that Freedom Rock? We'll turn it up, man. Hey y'all, it is still 8-8-18, 8-8-8, and it ain't too late to come back on with one more song. Yeah, if y'all just watched my last video, examples, I don't even know what I titled it, it's uploading as we speak. It's something about examples of gang stalking, Sideshow Bob, what did I call them? The clown Nazis, because they look like clowns. Just to let y'all know, I'm not saying, yeah, promoting, go out there and start filming them. However, it does make it die down. It's like, I'd say three times more when I'm not filming. But I choose not to focus my day on them. Yes, I notice them. You can't help when they run in your face and they do their goofy acts. But I really don't, they don't bother me anymore. They're a Sideshow Bob. They're a distraction is what I wanted to say. They take our eyes off of our purpose. They lower our energy, lower our spirits, lower our power, get our eyes off the Lord and what we're here to do. T.I.s, this is for you. You are angels. You have been sent here on this mission in this final hour to help the lost, save souls for Christ. And a lot of us are going to come back and battle the fallen. So if it makes you feel better too, because I know there's a few people out there that do this on a daily basis. However, I have better things that I want to look at rather than them. And I just wanted to film just a little quick thing on it, just so y'all could get a little glimpse in case people are new to it. They don't know how to recognize a stalker. I caught a handler who's not in red doing a signal, and I didn't notice him because I was focused on the red shirts. That's part of why it's covert harassment. They want us to know that they're doing this and make us feel surrounded and that everybody's in on it, which is a lie from the enemy. They're not all in on it. There's a lot of other people that don't know. However, most people that are in your neighborhood, they have been sent there. They are in on it. However, our God is stronger and bigger, and he gives us peace in the midst of the storm. And a lot of these people are scared of us. It's one of us against all of them. And it says in the Bible, thousands will fall on our side, right? If you have the Lord on your side, you can move mountains. Anyway, so I just wanted to say, yeah, I try to ignore it or just observe, but don't really, you know, don't let it ruin your day. And usually I laugh because it's pretty funny. Boy, that makes them mad, but it's a true laugh. I'm not faking it. And if you're having a hard time laughing and you want to release anger, what I used to do, now I can just naturally look at it and how ridiculous it is, go, ha 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 ha. I don't know, just that was a fake laugh, right? And then when you release that, it actually starts to make you want to kind of smile and laugh. Try to think of something that makes you laugh. Or just look at how ridiculous they are and go, man, all that for me? Yeah, you're important, T.I.s. Okay, but what I want to come on about now is why I'm back on here at nighttime. It's like 9. Wow, it just hit. I seriously looked over and I've been talking for a little while. It just flipped to 9:12 as I looked at it. It was 9:11, 9:12. So that's pretty cool. I wanted to tell y'all that the Lord has been showing me this is a high alert time. We have a new moon coming on Friday. There's a lot of stuff going on in our world. First, I want to tell y'all, Sis Karen from Sarah Forth Calling knows this. I almost left and went to Florida. I really, really, really wanted to go back to Florida. I miss it there. If y'all been following me, I lived on a boat last year that they stole, the enemy stole, but working through people. And I almost left several times in this past month. And the Lord basically stopped me. I didn't get the green light. I don't want to do anything just because I want to do it. I want to do only what Father says. So he's trying to get us closer to him in this final hour, root out any sin, uncovered or hidden sin, and that's covered, and uncover it, and help us to release it. Like I told y'all that, you know, I didn't know something had upset me a long time ago that the cops had done to me a long time ago, and I forgot that they did it. I hadn't told a soul. I'd repressed it. It happened when I was like 22. And once I released that, I think that was like my stronghold, because I still was resenting. And it's like, it's helped me not to even be craving alcohol. So praise the Lord for that. I don't crave alcohol. I shouldn't say that. A release from the pain, like to forget about the pain. And that was the route that I would do. Not anymore, Satan. Not today, Satan. So what's going on in Florida, you ask? What? Red skies at night. They have got red, blood red water. Biblical proportions. Sanibel Island, Sarasota, all the way almost up to where I lived before, which was St. Petersburg, Florida. I lived there for about 2 years before Key West. And yeah, it's so toxic that it's causing people to cough as soon as they go onto the beach. Of course, they can't even get in the water. All the fish have died. Basically all sea life, starfish. What really made me sad, I actually cried. They showed a little manatee. Well, they're not little, they're big. They're the sweetest little things. If y'all don't know, a manatee looks kind of like a little smush-faced dolphin. Like a pug dolphin is what they kind of remind me of. And they're sweet little creatures. This is a true story, just real quick. A man that was on a boat that was docked not next to my boat, but on the same dock as mine down at the end. I wasn't there when this happened. This is just word of mouth on the, you know, around the marina. He had drank too much and he fell into the water off the boat at the end of the boat. There's no lights out there. There's no way up. You have to swim and then you still can't get up to shore because it's like at a marina and there's a brick wall that goes up onto the shore and there's no way to crawl up if you're down there. And if y'all know, I got rescued by one hand when that happened to me before, where they had oiled my boat to make me slip. Yeah. And I believe it was an angel. But getting back to this man, he fell in the water. And, you know, he was a good swimmer, but he was still had been drinking. A manatee came up and pushed him back up onto the boat, y'all. And he got up on his boat. It's a true story. Those things are amazing. But anyway, yeah, they're all dead. You know, not they're all dead, but around that area, everything's dead in the water. And it's the worst red tide that people have ever seen there. A lot of these people that they've been interviewing from word of mouth that I heard have been there their whole lives. You know, 70, 80-year-old people saying they've never seen it like this. So that's biblical proportions where the rivers will turn to blood, right? Then we have the earthquakes everywhere. We know about the volcanoes. Then Hurricane Hector is headed to Hawaii. So just imagine what that's going to do if Hector hits the volcano. I don't know what that could do, but it can't be anything good. The Lord had me look up the meaning of Hector. It means bully, torment, and plague. Yeah. Then we have in Charlottesville, Virginia, we have martial law enacted. I told y'all the Lord's been warning me to be prepared for martial law. White supremacists are starting fights. And what it is, y'all, it's stemming from good old Hillary, and Obama Nation of Desolation invoking, you know, over the years, racial wars. We don't hate each other. We're all brothers and sisters in Christ, and we know that. I apologize to anybody that's, you know, dark skin that watched that other video I had, and I had Dave Chappelle at the end. I didn't realize he said the N-word in it. Honestly, I don't take offense to if somebody calls me honky or whitey or whatever. It doesn't bother me. I think it's kind of comical. But I know that's not a good word, and I apologize for that. I'm not prejudiced at all. I don't see color. I really don't. Obviously, you can tell someone's got blue eyes, someone's got brown eyes, someone's got blonde hair, someone's got black hair, someone's white, someone's black, of course. Someone's tan, hey, looking tan, you know, over the past few weeks. I'm not pasty white. You notice that, but it doesn't make a difference to me. It's I see your spirit. That's the spirit. You know, that's what I go by. And so most people are like that. Most people are kind-hearted people, I believe. However, the enemy has got a hold of them in this final hour. We're under a major, major red alert spiritual attack. Demons are taking over people everywhere. I'm seeing it. There was some YouTube video. I didn't even watch the whole thing. It came out about 2 weeks ago. I don't watch news, but it was on a news channel, and I happened to see it being reported on a YouTube channel. And it was two kids that had got strep throat, and of course they went into the doctors, who doctored them up real good and gave them medicine, which is means in the middle. And the Lord showed me, look up middle of the 7-year trib, 3.5 years. What was 3.5 years? Jesus had his 3.5 year ministry. Jesus was raised 3 days, right? There's something with middle, and medicine means middle and medieval. So it's pretty weird. The kids had strep throat. They got the medicine and they went from sweet kids overnight, y'all, this happened, into angry, hateful. The little boy, I want to say he was like 12. He was trying to kill himself with a knife. The little girl was 4. She was saying, she was screaming and yelling, saying she was going to kill her parents. Just horrible, horrible stuff. And these are demons. The medicine is making these children do these things. Be very, very mindful of what you put in this final hour. Thank you to my viewers that said, stay off the liquor, that it's spirits. And they're not like it was 20 years ago. You got that right. Spirits. That's why they call alcohol a spirit. It is demonic. And they're putting stuff into this now. I believe that the Satanists and the witches and the voodoo practitioners, oh my, are doing some sort of rituals over the alcohol and casting demons into these things. I know it sounds bizarre, but look at our world. Look at our world. It's like there's so much that we don't know, but we have been blessed who are guided to this channel, especially TIs and saints. We have been given eyes to see and ears to hear, and the reason why is we have a very special mission. That's what I've come on to tell y'all. I'm exhausted right now, and so I'm fumbling with my words. My throat is also, it feels like my throat is being shut down. I believe that the enemy does not want this out, so I'm trying to yell as well, because I don't want to be on camera right now and frighten y'all before bedtime. So that's going on. This horrible story, I read just a minute of it the other day about this. It was just the saddest picture. He looked just so helpless. He was taped up. 4 kids posted on Facebook how they tortured a disabled man. And they were Black Lives Matter. 4 black people tortured this white disabled man, cut his head, taped his mouth shut, punched him in the face, and made him curse Trump. I think he lived, though. And then on the flip side, now we have some white people in Charlottesville, basically acting like Nazis, screaming white supremacy and all that stuff. This is demonic. It is orchestrated by 2 of the most demonically infested people, Hillary and Obama. And yeah, they'll probably come get me. I had Homeland Security call me today, y'all, on the phone. Yeah, I'm not kidding. If y'all get a 000000 number, That's Homeland Security. I found that up. I found that out. I did some research, and it really is Homeland Security. Someone else told me the same thing, that they had that, and they found out the same thing. Let me see if it's on here, and I'll show y'all. Yeah, there it is. I don't want y'all to see all my numbers, but I'll just show y'all real quick. 00000. 11 hours ago. What time did they call me? 10:20 a.m., 10:21. Okay, so we have the red tide. We have the martial law. We have, you know, the race war, which is all bogus. We're all brothers and sisters. People are fleeing California in droves. And by the way, that's where Minister Paul lived. Who's still missing. They had a mass exodus while I lived there. I didn't do it though. The Lord had my back and told me to stay during Hurricane Irma. A mass exodus, which is what they wanted, and people disappeared, never to be heard from again during Hurricane Harvey and Hurricane Irma. And that's what they're doing for California right now. Just to let y'all know, I went through Hurricane Katrina. I did get out of the city for that. And Hurricane Irma, I did not leave the city for that. Both times I was guided by the Lord on what to do. That's why we must know Father's voice. Stay very close to Him in this final hour. He will instruct us. If you don't have a bunch of food, if you don't have a car like me, if you might even be homeless and somehow watching this, do not have fear. If you know the Lord, if you have a relationship with Jesus Christ of Nazareth, He will direct you on what to do. He will guide you, especially during the 3 days of darkness. He will take you to a place of safety, okay? So don't have any fear about that. If you don't know Jesus, this is a wake-up call. You need to know Him. You need to repent for your sins. Ask Him into your heart. Believe that He died on the cross for your sins. On the third day, He rose, and He's coming back to mount up. Us regulators that have been called to this channel, they're one of the 144. There's a bunch of us that are all part of a group, and then we've got teams of 20 to 30. Sis Karen has also been shown this, as well as a couple other brothers and sisters in Christ. All right? I told you about the red tide. Demons are taking over people. The storm in Hawaii, the fires, the earthquakes, the volcanoes, the mass animal deaths. The animals acting weird, running around in circles, flying into windows, doing all this kind of stuff. Following people. You know, coming up on the window and just looking in, not scared. This is biblical. This is apocalyptic. Wake up. Wake up. Hello. Wake up. Time for you to put a little makeup. Okay? So I'm going to show y'all what I was led to. On my walk yesterday, oh boy, got some phone things going on. I'm trying to make this under 30 minutes. I really am. Okay, let's see. On my walk yesterday, the Lord guided me down a side street. I've never seen this sign before. If y'all know, I've just been back in New Orleans a couple of months. I've been stuck in my room most of the time. I do go out and witness quite a bit on the weekend, but I have not, I promise you, I have not been down to where this sign was. Maybe I did and just didn't notice it. Maybe it wasn't up before, but I never saw it until yesterday. The Lord guided me right here to this sign, and I glanced at the sign, and this is a close-up of the sign. The Great Escape Gold Mine. Then there's ropes. I've had many dreams where one was stormtroopers were following me behind this red curtain, basically like the Wizard of Oz, the man behind the curtain. Pay no attention to the man behind the curtain. They're all talk. They can't do anything. They can't touch us. Saints of the Most High. T.I.s, they can't touch us. If you have God, if you know the Lord, You cannot touch us. And a rope came down and lifted me up out of the chaos. I had another dream of a rope lifting me out where meteors were striking. Grabbed onto the rope. Had another dream just recently of a rope letting gently a white horse down. And that was to be my horse to ride alongside of Jesus for the final battle. So that was very significant. But weirdly enough, it also says Gold Mine Saloon. If you take notice again, it says The Great Escape. I was shown the word, the van day before yesterday on my walk with a, just a must, somebody, you know, from the, this forearm down doing this on the side of the van, and it said, testing makes us stronger. Went around the corner, there was another van with, the whole thing was covered in puzzle pieces, you know, painting of a puzzle, and it said one word, escape. But what makes this even more significant, of course, it's got to be a black SUV. Then I looked, the SUV that's parked next to it, it's, yes, Saturn, which is Satan, Saturn worship. But I want y'all to take note of the plate. That's the sign, which I saw first. I took the picture, not noticing the plate, got up closer, and then I noticed the plate and the vehicle. This is the plate. 444. That's all I saw, and then I got home and looked at it again. WFY. We fly. It's amazing. It's amazing, y'all. If you have eyes to see, he will give you these signs. I got a picture of a Satanist trying to do a curse on me. That's the back of him. I sent it to Sis Karen from Sarah Fourth Calling, and she said it looked holographic when you zoom it up. Pretty weird. You see the Satanist, whatever, dumb symbol. Stealing another one of God's signs. Second. Here's a pretty picture. Here's my little girl. That was right across the street. I decided to stop and let them go because they were chanting. I mean, this happens to me everywhere I go. I'm used to it. I got home. This was the new, my screensaver changes on its own. This was the new screensaver. There it is. Not only the mountain, the island, the water, but check out the captioning. On the far eastern edge of an island called the Gathering Place, this expanse is a haven for wildlife and people alike. The Gathering. We're about to be out of here, y'all. The escape, the gathering, testing. Our testing is almost over. I'm in finals right now in school. I believe we're in finals to go up. It's coinciding at the same time. This is a really pretty sunset this morning. I got out early again. I've been up since 5, just so y'all know. It's like I feel an urgency when I wake up in the middle of the morning. Usually I'll go back to sleep and I feel like just urgent, urgent, urgent. The Lord led me to look in at this news channel. And I'm like, okay, what, Lord? It's a news channel. He said, look at the satellite. Get another picture of that. I got a close up of that. Or not a close up, but a zoom. Lightning bolt. On that other video, you can hear a thunder go off and it lightninged as I'm filming that short, like 4-minute video on the walk home. Then Sis Karen got lightning. I think lightning struck her bed. Yes. I mean, not her bed. I'm sorry. Above her bed, it struck her bed. Wow. My pants are really on fire now. Fire in the hole. Yeah, and but she wasn't home, praise the Lord, but it did something to her house. I don't want to misquote, so if y'all know her, Sarah Fourth Calling, she'll probably be talking about that. Okay, so I think that's all I want to show y'all on the camera, but yeah, there's a sense of urgency. I'm feeling it very strong. see. Just a second. Something is significant with the word middle. I'm going to do a little more research on that. I just want to get this out. Okay, also, I wanted to let y'all know, after Hurricane Katrina and Irma, which I was trapped in Key West, if I wanted to leave, I wouldn't have been able to. I wouldn't have been allowed. After Katrina, I had got out, but I was not allowed back in for 3 months. I could not go back in and look at anything because I left with just a bag of clothes and my surfboard. Yeah, I had a surfboard back then. I got some funny stories about that, but anyway. They thought I was part of the search and rescue mission on my way back in because I had it on top of my car back then. I was still drove. I started laughing. I could have got to the front of the line, but even back then I was honest. There was a long line to get back in. They called us in by zip code, and there still was like a long line. Then they're like, are you search and rescue? And I started laughing. I go, no. They go, okay. We thought because you got your board on top of your car. But anyway, that was pretty funny. So I'm telling y'all that when they shut the town down, you're not going to be able to leave. You're not going to be able to get back in. So you need to be prepared. If you have food and water and you've been guided to do that, that's great. I have not been guided to do that. Because in the wilderness, God provided for his people with manna. He broke up in a rock and water came out. He led people by a pillar of cloud, a pillar of fire, I think, at night and a cloud by day. I'm sorry, I should have wrote that down. It just popped into my head. But basically the gist of it is he leads his people. We don't have fear. But if you're being instructed to stock up and you have the means to do it, you have a place to keep it, which I really don't, then do it. But some of us are going to be called up. We're going to get our transformed bodies, Transformers, more than meets the eye. And we're going to come back down, kick the fallen aces out of here and rescue the lost. And maybe that's why I'm being shown the boat. We're actually going to be driving the boat. Thank you, sister, again, that mentioned that. I didn't even think of that. That's awesome. But I want to let y'all know that I do feel they're putting this into place with the, it's going to be on lockdown, okay? This is what targeted individuals, what Saints of the Most High, the 144K, this is what we have waited for our whole life. This is so exciting. Do not have fear. I got a Chapa alert. Do not have fear. This is our calling. This is our purpose. If you never fit in TIs, most of us didn't, right? Didn't know what we were doing. Most people, I know what I want to be when I grow up. I didn't know. I was like, I don't want to do that. I don't want to go to school. I'm a big kid now. I don't want to grow up. Bye, I'm a Toys R Us kid. I'm sorry, I really am tired. I'm like slurring my words. No, I'm not drinking. Okay, so I just want to stress again, be prepared. How do you prepare? You prepare by getting right with the Lord. That is our way out of the darkness and into the light. He will protect and guide us, okay? It's coming, y'all. Whatever they're about to implement, it is about to be on. Hillary and Obama had started this thing about basically the trying to instigate racial wars. If y'all don't know, I witnessed this when I lived in St. Pete. I've been so many places where these significant things have happened, and I believe that was the Lord's doing. So I can coach other people. They're going to be distraught. They're going to be looking for answers. The lost will be looking for answers. And we are the leaders in this final hour. That's why they've hit us so hard. We're leaders, y'all. Regulators, mount up. I forgot what I was saying. Okay. Anyway, Hillary and Obama started this whole racial thing. People aren't naturally like this. They try to make it like that, and then they try to breed it. Hate breeds hate, right? And their whole goal of this, basically they were paying people. There's things on Craigslist saying, we need street actors to go out and protest against Trump, to act angry. Some of these people are like D-minus actors too. They were ridiculous clowns. But yeah, they did that for a little bit of money. And that's what Hillary and Obama started. And that was to bring order out of chaos. That's why they're inciting riots, okay? Proverbs 6:16 through 19. The seventh sin, sowing discord among brethren, is an abomination to God. Psalms 71:2. I flipped to this today, y'all. After those two things in a row, one day before yesterday, and then one yesterday, and then now one today, so 3 days in a row. Psalm 71:2 is what I flipped to this morning. 71:2. Deliver me in thy righteousness, and cause me to escape. Incline thine ear unto me, and save me. Be thou my strong habitation, where I may continually resort. That's what we're to have. We're to have that with the Lord. And he will guide us, and he will help us to escape. T.I.s, this is for you. I know. Believe me, I know. You've been abused. Most of us have been abused. We've been ostracized. This is our whole life, not just the last year, our whole lives. We've been abused, ostracized, falsely accused, set up for crimes we didn't commit. We've been abandoned. We've been beaten. Seriously. A lot of us have had the poop beat out of us. Like a lot of us women have had abusive relationships and been raped. We've been unfairly imprisoned. Even if you didn't have to go to jail for a fake arrest, you've been imprisoned in your home. Basically, you've been isolated, and we've been made isolated, friendless. Family have been taken away from us. We've had a lot of us have had our friends and family and pets, big time with the pets, killed. We've been tortured. We've been mocked. We've been what I call one of the most hurtful ones, and I've had it so many times, and I know a lot of us have. We've been Judas Iscariotus out. Basically, really good friends and family have turned on us. We've been slandered. We've been rejected. We've had break-ins. We've had everything stolen from us. We've had our family disown us. We've been harassed. We've been embarrassed. We've been stalked on a daily basis, all these things going on. T.I.s, this is why. This is your calling to stand in this final hour. They're going to be freaking out when just a few of these things come on them. They won't know how to handle it. People are going to be killing themselves. They're going to be dying from fear. Men's hearts will fail them for fear. This is where we step up to the plate, and the Lord is saying he wants us to stand. This is our time to witness. This is our time to speak up. Put away your fear. Put away your, you don't think you're good enough, nobody's going to listen, your insecurities. You have been made perfect and whole and righteous through the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Father wanted me to tell y'all what I flipped to again today after Psalms 71:2 was Isaiah 66:5, especially for T.I.s. Hear the word of the Lord. Ye that tremble at his word, your brethren that hated you, that cast you out for my name's sake, saith the Lord. Be glorified. He shall appear for your joy, and they shall be ashamed. That's why I decided to come on and show y'all that video that I never video. I didn't know why I was videoing it yesterday, and it was for what he wanted me to say today. The Lord is just amazing. He wanted me to show y'all a little glimpse of what I go through and to let y'all know that you're not alone, that I totally get it. And my targeting is a million times worse than that little bit y'all saw. A million times worse. It's just they don't really, they know when we're filming, and so, you know, a few of them will come out, the lower level ones, but that's about it. They don't want to be caught on camera, and the demons know what we're doing, as do the high-ups that are using electronic equipment, but this is mostly demonic. It's a spiritual battle. I'd say 90% is spiritual and 10% is physically, like, you know, with electronics, all that, okay? I'm not downplaying the electronic weapons and stuff, man. I get it, too. That's why most of us TIs, we have bad teeth. They've been doing radiation to us our whole life. The dentists have put stuff in us. They've done root canals that they didn't need to do, and I believe it's because they jammed something up in there. They jammed it. Jam on it. Kimasabe, jam on it. Wow, that used to be my favorite song when I was like 12. The Lord is awesome. Anyway, I'm very tired, so again, I'm like jumbly bumbly with my words. I'm just trying to get this out. Okay, then I want to go to Isaiah 66:15. For behold, the Lord will come with fire in the hole, and with his chariots like a whirlwind, to render his anger with fury and his rebuke with flames of fire. And I've seen many dreams where I didn't know what they were. I was like, because back then, this was started like 4 or 5 years ago, I would have these dreams maybe once every 6 months with a bunch of these little bitty spinning whirlwinds. Now we're seeing them. They're actually coming to pass. So that's what I believe we're going to be seeing. For by fire and by his sword will the Lord plead with all flesh, and the slain of the Lord shall be many. The Lord doesn't want one to perish, even you witches. Yeah, he doesn't want you to perish. He's pleading. He's doing all this not because he wants to spank your tushy, because he wants to wake you up. He wants us all to go home. You have to turn to him. Go home. Are you too good for your home? Anybody know that movie? It just popped in my head too. Get it out. All right. And I'm going to roll out now because it's almost, and I've almost gone 37 minutes. Okay. Isaiah 66:19. I will set a sign among them. Look for the sign, y'all. And I will send those that, what? Again. So you know I'm not joking. Top of the page. Escape. I will set a sign among them, and I will send those that escape of them unto the nations. This is for you, targeted individuals that do know the Lord. This is for all the saints, all persecuted individuals. Saints of the Most High, end time saints. This is us. This is our purpose. I'm sorry, I just woke my poor little dog up. And she's filled with chicken tonight. Her tummy's overflowing. So she's like, out. I will set a sign among them, and I will send those that escape of them unto the nations. To Teresh, to Pul, to Lud, that draw the bow. Remember, we're warriors. There's the bow. And then also is the rainbow. To draw the bow. To Tubal, to Javan, to the isles, there's our island afar off, that have not heard my fame, neither have seen my glory, and they shall declare my glory among the Gentiles. This is what the Lord wants me to tell y'all. You targeted individuals, saints, 144K, the reason why we're all alone is we are strategically placed in our area. That's why I was brought back to New Orleans now that I've finished my training. In that area to where I can come back and be strong. Okay? We are specifically sent to that area which you're in. You have to proclaim, shout it from the rooftops, that Jesus is the way and the truth and the light, and no one comes to him. No way, witches, are you getting into heaven through the big door, the white door. You're not going to sneak in. You have to go through this narrow gate, which is Jesus. And he wants us to get out there and do what he's called us to do. whether it's to heal the sick, to cast out demons, to spread the good news, just to give somebody a hug and a smile and say Jesus loves you. Whatever your calling is, and you know what it is, get out there and do it. Like I said, even if it's just to help your neighbor and show love, that is a big, big deal in this final hour. People are hurting, they're lost, they're desperate, they're scared. We are the warriors. We're on the front lines. This is our calling, this is our mission. Step up to the plate. Isaiah 66:20. And they shall bring all your brethren for an offering unto the Lord out of all the nations upon what? Horses. There's our horses, regulators, in chariots and in litters and upon mules and in swift beasts to my what? Holy mountain. The Lord has been showing me holy mountain for the last few months. Holy mountain Jerusalem, saith the Lord. As the children of Israel bring an offering and a clean vessel into the house of the Lord. That's why we've gone through all these trials. Our vessel, which is our body, which is our spirit has to be clean. Our soul has to be clean to go up and be with Jesus. We can't come in there stinking up his house with our dirty ace feet like mine were. No, we have to be clean. And I will also take of them for priests. And for Levites, saith the Lord. Remember I told y'all the Lord finally showed me I'm a Levite? My last name means lion and Levite. Isn't that bizarre? New heavens and the new earth, which I will make, shall remain before me, saith the Lord. So shall your seed and your name remain. And it shall come to pass that from one new moon to another, there's a new moon coming on Friday, y'all. All of this goes together with what I've been shown. Just this one chapter in Isaiah. Isaiah 66 goes with everything. One new moon to another, and from one Sabbath to another, shall all flesh come to worship before me, saith the Lord. We're about out. We are about out, y'all. Okay, I love y'all. I thank you. A couple of people donated. Any amount helps. Thank you so much. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I'm still believing I'm going to get that boat, whether it's supernaturally or however, you know, a little sailboat or something cheap like that, and be able to save the lost, rescue the lost, minister. I don't know why that he's showing me this in this final hour, unless it's going to be in the supernatural, or I'm actually going to be doing this physically, rescuing people. But I've been shown a boat now for a couple of years, and it's really strong right now. He gave me the boat a year, almost, it was 1/1/1 of 2017, so it's been over a year and a half, and then they stole it 9 months later. 9 months, birth, isn't that funny, birthing. Okay, now I just wanna say, I don't really like country music, even though I'm from Texas. I do, there's a few songs that they're okay, but it's not really my thing. I know this was from the Lord. I think I've heard this song before, but I didn't know it. And as I was gonna make this video, he put it in my heart, look up, stand up. And I thought, stand up, that song. And I was like, I don't even remember who sings that. So all I typed in was the words that the Lord gave me, stand up. Song, stand up. And this is what popped up, and I went on it, and so I feel that this is what the Lord is trying to say. It was amazing because he specifically told me we need to start giving our testimony, telling others about Jesus and what he's done for us, and speaking out against all this monstrosity, the sickness that's going on in our world. People want out of this, but they're too scared because they think they're gonna come off as crazy. If we all stand up, there's nothing we can't do. United we stand and divided we fall. I love y'all and I thank y'all again. Anybody that's guided to donate, my PayPal is I write it in the description box because I don't know how to add it onto. Let me write it down real quick. I don't know how to. Can't do two things at once. It's called ADD. I don't know how to add it onto the box if somebody could help me, but I just put it in the description of what the video means. Anyway, this is it. It's B like in Bumblebee, Leah like Leah out of the Bible, and Ver. Be Leah Ver at Gmail. If anybody cares to donate, that would be very outstanding. Girl, you knocked me out. I love y'all. Stay strong and get ready. I believe martial law is on the way, and I'm sorry I can't talk tonight. I'm ready to go to sleep. Over and out.
Your Honor, I have a witness who can clear my good name.
Is this witness in the courtroom?
Yes, Your Honor. Mr. Mel McDaniel. He's sitting right. Oh, Your Honor, could I make a motion in front of the court, please? Thank you. Goodbye!
I have to do it like this so they don't get me.
You ever had a hot date, one of those can't wait, things go a little too far. In the middle of a good night, have you ever got right in the back seat of your car? I said, stand up. Have you ever been there? Stand up. Identify, stand up, tell us all about it, stand up, testify.
That is us, Saints. Stand up and testify. I love y'all.